we were absolutely astonished. We had no inkling from National Highways, as now is, that there was any threat to that bridge at all.
When you're a national organisation and you're dealing with what appears to be a relatively small group of people, it's easy to ignore them and just carry on and act with total impunity.
What National Highways did here was contrive an alternative reality whereby a bridge that was in perfectly good condition became a threat to public safety. It might fail, it might collapse.
It is indeed their assertion, but I can only conclude that those people who have come to that conclusion have not read their own engineers' reports.
Virtually every page, it's telling me that there's really nothing much wrong with the bridge.
And all it needed was sort of pointing underneath the arch barrel. Pointing arch barrels is quite a common way of strengthening bridges, which is cheap and easy to do.
What's more, they appear to spend a lot more getting rid of it than they would to maintain it.
It's an honour to be looking after our railway heritage. It's something really precious and interwoven into the history of our country.
Engineers have a duty to not only look at carbon footprints, but sort of the social and archaeological and historical aspects of what they do.
When I saw what had happened to it, the best way to describe it is sheer vandalism. I'd say it's an ecological disaster, environmental disaster, and the people who did it cannot possibly be proud of what they've done.
I think the word travesty just about sums it up, really.
The bridge creates an opportunity to link two heritage railways and boost the local economy.
It's very hard to put a figure on that, but it's certainly worth the investment of maintaining a structure such as this.
If you want to bring economic benefits and visitors into Kirby and into the Upper Eden area, this is the attraction that has got to succeed.
The permissive development powers that had been used were only for an emergency and temporary basis. So as we're aware, Eden District Council has asked for a retrospective planning application to be submitted.
My hope is that the people in the Eden District rise up against it and put in lots of objections.
Well, the application should certainly be refused. I think it's a disgrace that it was ever happened in the first place.
They have to dig it out, admit that they're wrong and dig it out, repair it, put it back as it should be.
I'd love to see it re-excavated and opened up once more.
Whilst ever it remains infilled, Great Musgrave Bridge will stand as a monument to National Highways' failure and dishonesty.
You cannot look after heritage by drowning it in concrete. That's just a way to destroy it.